Good morning to everybody. We are discussing definite integration. So definite integration for 7 marks and 2 marks are completed. Actually 4 marks will be given from areas, but areas is deleted for this year, only for this COVID year. It will be there for objective. So we will discuss areas at least a little bit too now. So we will go for areas, not there for your syllabus IBE. We already discussed A of x equal to, according to first fundamental theorem of integral calculus, A of x equal to integral of 0 to x f of t dt is called as the area function. We already discussed it. So this one we will write like this. Integral of f of x dx from a to b. What is meant by the a of x equal to integral of a to b f of x dx? We already discussed it. What is this? This gives you the area under the curve. Area under the curve made with x axis between the limits a and b, we already discussed in the basics, beginning of the chapter. Now, if f of x is a continuous function, f of x is a function from a gamma b to, for example, 0 to infinity, I will take the present first. Means if it is a positive function, y is a positive function, here range is 0 to infinity, means only positive values, then f of x will be like this, only positive. This is f of x, 0 to infinity. So this is f of x. Between the limits a and b, I mean. So this is x equal to a somewhere, and this is x equal to b somewhere. So in between the limits, made by the x-axis, made by the curve with x-axis, between the limits a and b. So integral of a to b fx dx gives you area under the curve. Gives you area under the curve between a and b with positive x-axis. Here positive x-axis, but need not be positive x-axis. Can be with x-axis. Okay. So what I want to say is, first point, if f is a mapping from a comma b to some 0 to infinity, then integral of a to b fx dx is known as area under the curve. A of x is area under the curve. Area under the curve made with x-axis between the limits a and b. Between the limits a and b. Represented with a of x. A of x is area. So this shaded region, this shaded region is known as area under the curve. Like the same, if f is a negative function, means range is from minus infinity to 0. Range is from minus infinity to 0. Then how will be the function? So obviously minus infinity to 0. So it will coming from minus infinity and coming to 0, somewhere like this. If I want between a and b, between a and b. So this area I need. This area is nothing but, this is always negative. So y is always negative, but area cannot be negative. But area cannot be negative. Area will treat always positive. So we'll take a of x equal to integral of a to b minus f of x dx. Minus f of x dx. At this only you can write like this. Integral of a to b f of x dx whole mark. Whole mark. What I want to say is area cannot be negative. Here the function is negative, so you will get area in terms of negative. So if I keep minus, minus half minus, it automatically becomes plus. So area cannot be negative. This total area I need. So then the area will be found like integral of a to b minus f of x dx, or just integral of a to b f x will find, you will get a negative value, will take absolute value, modulus of a to b f of x dx. Like this. If the function is from a to b to r, if the function is सम ए का मा बी टू आर रियल नंबर सेट एंड इट इज पास टू टिल सी एंड देन इट इज बिकमिंग नेगेटिव लाइक योर साइन टर्म इफ यू टेक योर साइन टर्म इट विल बी लाइक दिस सो it is like our sine function it will be positive in one quadrant negative in the other quadrants like so in that if you observe what will get integral of a to b if I am taking it is cutting x axis at some c then I need to take this area as well as this area if I am taking this area up to b is here if I am taking this area this is positive will get this is negative will get total area zero will total area zero unit if you do directly a to b so don't do like that so what you have to do is if the function is from a to b to a comma b to r and is discontinuous at r is not differentiable at c or it is intersecting x axis at c then what you have to do is split into two parts you know already a to c c to b so you can write like integral of a to c fx dx plus integral of c to b this is negative c to b so we will take area is minus f of x dx is same you can write like this integral of a to c fx dx plus modulus of integral of c to b fx dx instead of taking minus if you take absolute value it will be better So I need to think about negative because area cannot be negative. Means I need this area positive. For example, this is 2. This is 1 by 2 area square units. Then this also 1 by 2 square units. Then total area should be 1 unit, not 0 units. If it is taking f of x directly, you will get minus 1 by 2. That's why you take modulus. Modulus of minus 1 by 2 is plus 1 by 2. 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2 is 1. Like that you need to take. So even if you keep modulus here also no problem because positive is only you will get positive only. So we can write modulus of a to c f of x dx plus modulus of c to b f x dx simply. If it is a continuous function and cutting x axis at some c, it is some positive and some negative. Then you can make them both are positive by taking modulus. Then you will get the total area. Next, if there are two functions. How to find the area between the two functions? How to find the area between the two functions? If there are two functions, f of x and g of x like this, I want the area between f x and g of x. This area if I want. So, what do I get if I do integral of a to b f x dx? Integral of a to b f x dx gives me this whole area f of x. With x axis, this whole area is given. And integral of a to b g of x dx, if I do, what do I get? I get area under the curve with x axis, this area. I want area between the two, means this whole area minus this area gives me this area only. So what I want to say is fx minus gx. This only will write integral of a to b fx minus gx. Dx, fx minus dx, dx gives me area between the two curves, fx and gx. Here, if fx is more than gx, fx is more than g of x, and f of x, g of x are the two functions. F is a mapping from a comma b to r, and g is a mapping from a comma b to r. There are two functions between the limits. From a comma b to r, then such that there are two functions which are from a comma b to r. So if fx is more than gx, then I will do like this. If, for example, the case is reverse, means this is fx and this is gx, means if fx is less than gx, then I need to write different. If fx is less than gx. Then area function is integral of a to b g of x minus f of g of x minus f of x. If the function is f of x, g of x is more than f of x, means f of x is less than g of x, then you will get a gx minus fx. Instead of checking which is upper curve, which is lower curve, always upper curve minus lower curve will do, then automatically this whole area minus this area gives me this in between area. That is basic thing. Now, if I am unable to find which is upper curve, which is lower curve, instead of finding every time checking, you do one thing. Keep modulus. Modulus of integral of a to b fx gx, my fx minus dx whole dx gives you whenever less than 0 or more than 0. Nothing will happen. Because you will take only modulus. If it is less, fx is less than gx, you will get negative here, but we are taking modulus. So automatically you will get positive area. So area it is. Finally, what I want to conclude is, area cannot be negative, you need to take always positive area. So this is fx minus gx. Modulus if you keep, you will get actual area between the two curves. So like this, we will proceed. Next, if fx and gx are intersecting at C somewhere, then extending, then we will go for the next case, fifth case, like this. There are two curves like this. I want the area between the two curves between the limits A and B. Then these two are intersecting at some C. Then same thing we will do. Integral of A to C, C to B. So what I want to say is, area function A of x equal to integral of A to C fx minus dx whole dx plus integral of C to B. Here, if this is f of x, this is g of x. Here g of x is overtaking f of x. So we will take g of x minus f of x. G of x minus f of x. Yes. And here also you can write like this. Integral of a to c f of x, integral of a to c f of x minus g of x dx plus modulus of integral of c to b f of x minus g of x can do, but this automatically will get positive value only. So that gives area between the two curves. If they are intersecting at C, the split between A to C and C to B like that. More than one point, if they are intersecting also, you can take A to B, A to C1, C1 to C2, C2 to C3 like that, and so on, Cn to B. So like that you can split. Like anything. So this is how to find the area between the two curves. Next, sometimes curves will be like this. So I'm taking one circle. R will take. Two parabolas. This is one parabola, this is another parabola. I want the area between these. I want the area between these. Means, from 0 to some t, means till the intersection point, this is the first curve, f of x, and this is the second curve, g of x, t to b, I want. Then, 0 to t, f of x we need to take, t to b, g of x we need to take. So, if the curves are like this, then this is integral of 0 to t f of x dx plus integral of t to b g of x dx gives you the total area with x axis. Total area with x axis. Because f of x is making with x axis up to here, then g of x is making area with x is this. So, f of x, g of x both covering area is this part. So, like that. If they are symmetric, then, if I want the total area, twice that gives me total area. So, I will find half of this, then into 2 gives me total area, if they are symmetric like that. Sometimes, our curves will be like this. Best example for this, one more best example for this is, we can take sin x and cos x. If you take cos x, it will be like this. Cos 0 is 1. Cos 0 is 1. But cos 90 is 0. Like this you get. And sin x curve is like this. Sin 0 is 0, but sin 90 is 1. So sin x curve is like this. This is cos x. And this is sin x. This is sin x. Then area between the two curves, triangle made by the two curves, if I want with x axis, then this is the triangle made by the two curves with x axis. Means from 0 to pi by 4, these two will intersect at pi by 4. So 0 to pi by 4, I will take sin x curve, and pi by 4 to pi by 2, I will take cos x curve. Means this area, if I want, I will take 0 to pi by 4 sin x dx plus pi by 4 to pi by 2, I will take cos x dx, and keep modulus to always be better. Even if you get negative, you can take only positive values, because this is how we will do. So integral of sin x dx, we know how much, minus cos x between the limits 0 to pi by 4 plus cos x is sin x between the limits pi by 4 to pi by 2. Like this we can find the area. Like this we can find the area. Here you are getting negative area observed, but I need this. It's also a positive value. So that's why we need to keep modulus always better. That negative will be avoided. So like this we can do the sums. Next, sometimes curves will be symmetric about x-axis. Sometimes curves will be symmetric about x-axis or y-axis like this. If I want from 0 to a, whole area between the curve and x equal to some a. The whole area of the curve between 0 to a at x equal to a, means I want this whole area. Then if you observe, this is symmetric about the x-axis. This curve is symmetric about the x-axis. So we will take 0 to a upper curve. If I take 0 to a, the f of x dx, f of x, then I will get this upper area with x-axis, positive x-axis I told. So you will get this upper area. So integral of 0 to a, fx dx here gives me this upper area. So total area is 2 times of this. Total area is 0 to a here, again 0 to a here. So that's why this is symmetric, I am saying. So 2 into 2, if I find this, twice of this gives me total area. Like the same, you can go for circle also, if it is a circle. You can find this area, and into 4 gives me total area, if it is an ellipse also. So if I find this area, into 4 gives me total area of the ellipse. So all this we will do in areas. So like this, we can find the areas of all the curves, functions, whatever may be given, made by the f of x with x axis or with y axis. If he is asking about area made by the curve with y axis, means x equal to f of y, curve will change, like x in terms of y will change, then we will find the area of the curve. For example, curve is like this, made with y axis I want. So this is between a to b with y axis. Means I need to do integral of a to b f of y dy. Same everything whatever we did till now, all we do will do with f of y dy. Instead of f of x dx, with y axis gives me f of y dy. So gives me area of the same curves with y axis between the limits a and b gives me. Like this, we will find with y axis also. Same concept, but only changing f of y dy, g of y dy, f of y minus g of y, two terms are there like this. I want between the two, I can use this f of y minus g of y also, I can get the area between the two curves.
So like this we will find the areas. Now we'll go for exercise sums. Before going for exercise, first of all we'll discuss the curves, some curves which you already know, equation of the curve and how the curve will be. Then we'll go for the areas, because all the curves may not be completed till now for you, I think. So if it is a circle, you know the equation of circle, x square plus y square equal to r square. Represent a circle whose center is at origin and having the radius r. These curves you know. Next, if the center is somewhere at h comma k, then equation of circle is x minus h whole square plus y minus k whole square equal to r square. Represent the circle whose center is at h comma k and radius is r. This is somewhere like this. Now, this is h comma k, and whose radius is r radius. Then equation of the circle is like this. You already know all this, just I am recollecting. If completed, not completed, you can learn at least now. Next, this is equation of circle. Next, equation of a parabola. Equation of parabola is y square equal to 4ax. It is a parabola symmetric with x-axis. Because if you observe y is square, so y is a even function. So you will get y square equal to 4x is a curve like this. Y is equal to plus or minus root 4x. Means function can be positive and negative, but x is always positive. So the function is like this. So this is a parabola. Y square equal to 4ax always passes through origin. So vertex is at origin. Y square equal to 4ax is a parabola whose vertex is at origin 0, 0. And focus is at a comma 0. This you already know. If not known, yet at least the basics you can learn now. Now this is equation of parabola, which is symmetric about x-axis. Most important, this is symmetric about x-axis. Like, if y square equal to 4ax, x square equal to 4ay, x square equal to 4ay, is a parabola symmetric about y-axis. Means if I fold on the y-axis, both will point. So symmetric about y-axis. So like this, x square equal to 4ay gives me symmetric about y-axis. Again, vertex is at origin only. Here vertex is at origin only. And focus is at 0, a. This is focus. Represents a parabola. This is also parabola. Only thing is, this is symmetric about x-axis, y square equal to 4ax. X square equal to 4a is symmetric about y-axis. These parabolas you learnt at our 10th class also in quadratic equations. There you learnt like ax square plus bx plus c. Through the graph I know, you will get a parabola like this. What is the difference between the t? 3. Here, b square minus 4ac is greater than 0, means cutting x-axis at 2 points. Here, b square minus 4ac less than 0, so it is not touching x-axis. No real roots. And another curve is like this. Here, b square minus 4ac equal to 0. Means roots are equal, so touching the axis at only 1 point. And what about this? What is the difference between these two? These two are one and same. Here also b square minus 4ac greater than 0 only because intersecting at 2 points. Only difference is, here a is greater than 0, here a is less than 0. A is more than 0 means curve is concave upwards and this is concave downwards. Like this, we can say about the parabolas. So equation of parabola y is equal to ax square plus bx plus c is a curve. This is so see ax square quadratic in terms of x is always curve like this. Curve like this. If a is less than 0 here, then it will be like this. So these are the parabolas. Anyhow, there is a separate chapter parabola. This that you will learn in that topic clearly. Just I need the shapes for doing areas. That's why I'm explaining all this. Just we need, if we need area between 0 to a, area made by this curve, if I want, I can find this area in 2, like this we will need. We need more than that, we don't want for here. Completely you learn in the parabola chapter. Parabola, there is a separate chapter, you learn everything there. But if it is completed, it will be, my work will be somewhat easier. I think it is not completed, that's why I am explaining basics at least. Next, ellipse. Ellipse is almost a circle. The only difference is this major axis, minor axis. Here, eccentricity is less than 1. Forget about eccentricity. Parabola eccentricity is equal to 1, ellipse less than 1, hyperbola more than 1. What is eccentricity? What is focus? All these you will learn in those chapters. Parabola is a separate chapter, ellipse is a separate chapter, hyperbola is a separate chapter. You will be learning there. Just basics I need, that's what I am saying. This is a hyperbola, sorry, this is an ellipse whose standard equation is x square by a square plus y square by b square equal to 1. So x square by a square plus y square by b square always represents an ellipse. Always represents an ellipse. Always represents an ellipse whose center is 0, 0, whose center is 0, 0, and the major axis is 2a, minor axis is 2b. Means this is a comma 0 and this is minus a comma 0. And this is 0 comma b and this is 0 comma minus a. So this is 2b, this length is 2a. So forget about all those, you learn at once. The ellipse chapter separately, forget about that. Presently, we need to know general equation of an ellipse is x square by a square plus y square by b square equal to 1. And it is symmetric about x axis as well as about y axis. If you fold like this, same. If you fold like this, same. Point same. So symmetric here, both x and y axis. So if I find this area, into 4 gives me total area. If I find this area between 0 to a or 0 to b, like I can find this area, then a to 0 or b to 0, 0 to b, I can find this area with respect to x axis or with respect to y axis, dx or dy. I can find this 1/4 of the area, then I can find the whole area. If a equal to b in the ellipse, automatically becomes circle. Ellipse is nothing but also a circle if a equal to b, major axis equal to minor axis. All those you will learn at that chapter only. So these are the basic you need to know before going for the exercise. Next class we will start the exercise. Be clear about all the concepts first.